One of the key talking points of the amendment of the Electricity Act processed last year was the need to introduce harsh and deterrent punishments to vandals amidst the increasing prevalence of vandalism. Now, a section of the Electricity Regulatory Authority has been licensed by the Director of Public Prosecution to prosecute offences under the Electricity Act 2022 as amended.
Well, before, ordinarily, the Office of the DPP would be in charge of all those kind of prosecutions. But because we are also hampered sometimes by staffing levels, so we institutions like ERA come to us and seek our assistance that they have issues in their sector which needs to be prosecuted criminally, and they have staff who can ably and competently help the Office of the DPP in prosecuting those matters.
Five ERA legal staff have been licensed in the framework that Alex Baganda, the Assistant Director of Public Prosecution, describes as a natural and normal process in which the DPP can license employees of government agencies to prosecute cases in their areas of interest. To Harold Obiga, the Director of Legal Services at the Electricity Regulatory Authority, the partnership has improved the efficiency of prosecuting offences under the Electricity Act 2022.
I would say close to a 99.9% efficiency rate in terms of the prosecution that we are seeing, in terms of conviction, but also more importantly in terms of deterrence to the community and to the sector. So previously, yes, a matter would come up, but because of maybe lack of familiarity on what this specific electricity vandalism is about, the conviction rates were really significantly low. And because they were significantly low, we're just seeing a vice on the increase. But now we are able to have a better conviction rate, and consequent to that, we have a better deterrence rate.
This was during an interaction with the selected judges and the Electricity Regulatory Authority in Kampala. Vandalism is one of the challenges that the sector has grappled with over the last 1 year, and the sector is losing approximately 500 billion shillings every year to the vice. Story by Benan Ojambo for the news.